I'm continuing my project on updating my Mandalorian cosplay armor using only free STL files. These are the gauntlets I made using free files that I found. Hey everyone, Danny here with Vader Dad Builds. I'm getting closer with finishing my Mandalorian project. I'm replacing the EVA foam armor with 3D printed parts made from free STL files. In this video, I'll be going over the gauntlets, which are my favorite parts I've done so far. Alright, so let's get started. Here are the parts that I need for my upgraded Mandalorian armor. And these are the parts that I finished from the first two videos. I found a couple great free files for the gauntlets, but I wasn't sure if they would fit over my hand if I printed them in one part. So I printed a test piece to find out. And it's a good thing I did. My hands won't fit, so I'll have to split these parts in half. I used mesh mixer to easily splice them in the middle. These parts have holes here that I can use to connect the two halves later. Now I'm ready to start printing. I start with both halves of the right gauntlet. If you've watched my other Mandalorian videos, you know the drill by now, so I'll spare you the details. If you haven't, I have another video that goes over getting a metallic finish on the armor. Be sure to check that out next if you want to see that process. After getting the metallic finish, I just want to add one more detail. I use some black paint and cut out a few Mandalorian letters with a Cricut, and I apply them here. Last step on this part is to attach the two halves. To do this, I have a 1mm elastic cord and I cut four pieces about 12 inches each. This is longer than you need, but it'll make this process much easier. First, I thread one cord through these four sets of holes toward the center of the two halves. Then I do the same for the four sets on the back. Now I tie the first set together in a loop. You want to make sure to pull it tight with no slack so it'll hold the two halves together. And then I do the same to the other cord. Now I just cut off the excess. Now the other side. I thread both cords through one of the pieces. Then I pull both halves together to thread the cord on the other side. And the same thing here. Pull these tight before tying the cord. Then cut off the excess and pull the pieces apart so the cord pops inside. There we go. It opens so I can get my hand through and it is tight enough to stay shut. And there's the finished right gauntlet. Another part to mark off. On to the left gauntlet. After splitting the part in two, I print each half. And again, the process of smoothing out the part before painting. Then I paint, add the clear coat, and the graphite powder. In addition to the gauntlet, there are three other parts included to help hold the LED lights in place. There's no reason to print those though, you're not going to need them. I got these LED lights from Amazon. They're a very tight fit and will stay in place. It's best to push them in from the front and pull the wires from the back. You need to use a bit of force to get them in, but then they'll stay in place. I do the same for the remaining 11 LED lights. After getting the lights in, I leave about 4 inches of insulation past the openings and strip off the rest. After doing this for all the wires, I twist all the blue wires together and the same for the black wires. Before covering these up, I test them to make sure they all light up. Then I solder each set of wires together. And I use heat shrink to insulate them. I also added this momentary push button switch so I can control the lights. As I expected, the 9-volt battery didn't fit with all the wires inside, so I ended up cutting the cover and using electrical tape to cover the rest. I'll figure out where to put the 9-volt battery once I start putting the whole suit together. And now the last step of attaching the two halves with the elastic cord. Here's the finished left gauntlet complete with LED lights. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe and hit that notification button if you want to see more like it. Thank you for watching.